Our relationship could be wonderful, Sara, if you focused on me half as much as you focused on school.
Well, you knew what you were walking into when you decided to be with me. And I told you, being a doctor was everything.
Yeah, Sara, I know that. I have dreams and aspirations too, and I still have time for you at the end of the day.
Oh. So I'm a bad girlfriend now, is that what you're saying?
No, Sara. I'm not saying that.
I thought I could handle being in love and school, but I can't juggle the both of them as easily as you can, Matt.
Sara, I know. It's hard. It's hard for me too.
You deserve better than me, Matt. And maybe I shouldn't be your girlfriend anymore.
Don't say that, Sara. I don't... Sara! Damn it, Sara. Don't do this to me. Pick up, Sara.
Hey, this is Sara. Not here right now, so leave a message at the beep, and I'll get right back to you.
Sara, I'm so sorry. All those things I said, it wasn't me trying to bash you as a girlfriend. I miss you. I miss seeing you and being around you. I love you, and you are the only girlfriend for me. Call me back, Sara, please.
Hey girl, look at you looking all special. Where you going with your bad self?
I'm just taking Matt out for dinner at Rosie's.
Ooh, fancy much?
Well, I figured, you know, he's always spoiling me. So it's my turn now.
Well, that's cool. Wait a minute. Is that the winter internship from NYC?
Yes, it is.
I thought you weren't gonna apply for that. That you and Matt were gonna have a much needed holiday vacation.
I know. But I couldn't help myself. And it's like a 1 in a million chance that I would actually get in. And I figured, why tell him and get in a big argument over me promising that I was all his for the holidays and I'm breaking our plans once again if I didn't even get in?
Okay, so... what are you gonna do if you do get in?
If I get in, there's no way in hell I would be able to give up this opportunity. And I can't continue this relationship when I know my focus would be 100% on my medical internship.
But he's perfect for you.
I know.
and you love each other.
I know, Blake. But during last semester's midterms, we had this big argument over me not giving him enough attention and being around, and we nearly broke up.
But you didn't. Because you had hot, sweet makeup sex, and you worked it out.
I know. Do you know what? I'm probably freaking out for nothing. It's time for the moment of truth.
Dear Sarah Elizabeth Jones, on behalf of NYU Langone Children's Hospital Special Winter Internship Program, I am pleased to extend to you an offer of temporary employment as an intern reporting to Dr. Maxmore.
You got in!
I got in!
Oh, wow, it starts the day after Christmas.
So, what does that mean for you and Matt?
There's no way I can turn this internship down. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and I can't continue to be with Matt and put him through what I did before.
So, you're gonna throw away the love of your life for an internship? Hey, babe. You look beautiful.
Thanks. And you look handsome yourself.
I try for you. Hey, Blake. What's up, man? Nothing much. Just excited to be spending some much-needed quality time with my lady before I fly off to L.A. for film school for a year. I feel you. In film school in L.A.? That's amazing, man. I'm happy for you. Thanks. So, when you leaving?
January 2nd.
Wow, that's right after New Year's Day. Yeah, I know. That's why every second counts with my baby. Yeah, every second counts, Sarah.
I know, Blake.
I hope no one winds up crying at the end of the night. What, Blake? Why would anyone be crying? What's he talking about, Sarah?
I don't know. He's a little drunk. Good night, Blake.
This is not gonna be good. What's that about?
You know Blake. He's, you know, Blake.
Yeah, that is right.
So, are you excited to go to film school in L.A.?
Yeah. I'm excited to learn everything there is to know about filming. And the thought of being on a Hollywood film set is mind-blowing.
Well, I'm just so happy for you.
Thanks, babe. It's all because of you.
Oh, stop it, babe. This was in you all along.
Yeah, but you pushed me. And you believed in me,
even when I didn't. And none of this would be happening if it wasn't for you. I'd like to propose a toast to the best girlfriend in the universe.
Babe, you don't have to say that.
Yes, I do. Because it's true. Cheers. Listen, I know that things have been rocky the last few months with us, with the thought of doing the whole long distance thing. And I felt like you didn't care and you felt like a bad girlfriend.
Matt, look, about that. I can't afford to come see you in LA.
Then I'll pay for the both of us to come see each other.
Matt, you know how I feel about that. I don't like owing anybody anything, and I like to pay my own way.
Fine. Then you can pay me back. But just a heads up, the money you give me is gonna go towards our wedding in the near future.
What? You wanna marry me after everything I put you through?
Yes, Sara. Why do you sound so surprised?
Because I'm mean to you, and I hurt your feelings, and I'm a control freak.
Sara, we've been dating since freshman year of college. You don't think I know that? You're also sweet, sensitive, and caring. And sometimes I'm clingy and messy. Newsflash, Sara. No couple is perfect. I'm willing to do whatever it takes to make this work. Just like I know you would do the same. Because we love each other. Sara, I want to spend the rest of my life with you. Get married, have kids, the whole American dream. I can see it now. Me being one of the best Hollywood film directors with Oscars and Emmys, and you being the best pediatrician there is.
But what if, Matt, what if we don't wind up together in the end?
Don't say that, Sara. I hate it when you go all negative like that. I'm willing to do whatever it takes. Aren't you?
Yes.
So, does that mean that we're on the same page?
Yeah. Yeah, we are.
Whew. Oh, you scared me there for a second.
Sorry.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, your troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself the Yuletide gay. From now on, your troubles will be miles away. Here we are, it's an olden day.
seems to agree.
Blake, he says that he's all in with me. He said he wanted to spend the rest of his life with me. What am I gonna do now?
Gee, I don't know. Maybe stay with him and stop letting your insecurities get in the way?
Blake, you know I can't stay with him, especially now. I mean, the longer I stay with him, the harder it's gonna be for him to get over me.
Well, what do you want me to say, Sara? That you're doing the right thing? Cause to be 100, I think you're making a big ass mistake. I wish I had a woman who would do half the things Matt does for you for me. I would marry that woman.
Okay, Blake, I get it. You don't agree with what I'm doing, and that's okay. But you're still my best friend and I need your help. Just like all the times I had your back with your baby mama Bianca.
Oh, so you're gonna bring my baby mama into this, really?
Yep.
That's cold, man, even for you.
What? Like, I'm desperate. And you're a savage, and now I need you to teach me how to be a savage like you so that Matt will break up with me. Because I tried to break up with him, and I can't.
Man, this better not come to bite me in the ass.
Break up with who? Who are you talking to, Sarah?
Oh, it's just Blake. You know, him and Bianca broke up again.
Again? Really? Wow.
No, we didn't.
What? Sarah, what was that?
Don't be telling him lies.
Blake, you gotta go? Okay, bye.
I know this B-word didn't just hang up on me. Babe, are you okay?
Yeah. You know, Blake, he needed to vent.
Yeah. They just wish Blake and Bianca would stop playing these stupid little games with each other. And just be honest, I mean, they have a son together, for Christ's sakes. They can't keep breaking up and getting back together like this. Because this is going to affect Josiah in the long run. When he starts having his own relationships with women, he's going to have trust and abandonment issues.
Like you?
Yeah. My parents cheated on each other like it was second nature. And it messed me up real bad. That's the reason I'm the way I am now. So clingy and scared of being abandoned. I'm so glad that I got you, Sarah. I know you would never break my heart.
Yeah. You know, I wouldn't.
Sarah, you made me believe in love again.
Oh. That's so sweet.
Are you gonna cry?
No. Come on, let's go to bed.
Okay, I'll be there in a second. I gotta pee. Okay?
Okay.
This is gonna be a lot harder than I thought.